Que você está numa casa aberta e você não sai de dentro dela, porque você já perdeu o conceito de liberdade. A sua cela está aberta e você não sai. E às vezes você tem um conceito de ansiedade de liberdade maior, que lhe prendem na maior corrente, na prisão máxima, e você arrebenta e foge. Aí está a força no conceito que você tenha de liberdade ou não.
You've got to realize one thing, and that is you need to tame your wild, crazy mind. You got to tame it. All right? Your mind has a very, very bad habit, which we call self-cherishing. And I call it, what about me? What about me? What about me? What about me? And it's a bore, and it's a drag, and nobody wants to hear it. So you can just shut up and get off of it and give. That's all. Give. Give. Be here and give. Connect with people. Right? And you're so busy giving, you don't have time to think about yourself. You're going to be a lot happier.
This is the time for awakening for humans on the planet. This is the time to wake up out of the madness, because the history of humanity is basically the history of insanity. But for the first time in the history of this insanity, is the insanity threatening to destroy us. Mad intelligence. That's what humans have developed. We could call it also, you could call it cleverness. They're all clever, but mad. Mad intelligence. So we are coming to the end of this one way or another. Either we destroy ourselves or we wake up out of that dream, the nightmare. But to see your own madness is the beginning of healing and sanity, because there is in every human being not only the madness, there's also the sanity. Through the media, mostly what you get is the madness. But at the same time, there are millions of other humans who already have that awakening within them so that they can hear. It's liberating to see we are mad. Some people say, that's depressing. It's not depressing, it's liberating.
Yeah. gradually begins to develop. One of the first things a child learns is his or her name. I am John. I am, and then come other things after the children grow up. I am a boy. I am a girl. I am strong. I am weak. The ego is always built on identification with this or that. The word I, the way it's used conventionally, is perhaps the greatest delusion. Because when you say I, you think you know who you are.
I'm here.
The child gets toys. That's my car, little toy. That's mine. Somebody takes away the toy, child is in extreme agony. It's mine.
Right here's a small list of all the things that scare me to death. I can't stand things that I can't understand, and I especially hate things I can't command. I don't like the unfamiliar, and I've got to be first. But I tell ya, without me, you could never be a Mandela. Who would know what Muhammad Ali without me? My name is Lust, I'm not a real person, more like a quality. Attach myself behind your eyes temporarily, and blind you to anything you think you might wanna be. Make you promise me everything.
I was 3 or 4 years old, you know, going out in front of my house and, you know, having a huge poop, like, you know, right in front of the house on the sidewalk, and then running inside excited to bring my parents out, my mom and dad, and show them what I had done. I was so excited about it. And what was I was whipped. I was spanked and whipped for it. And violently, you know, shame on you. Look what you did.
We've been trained and conditioned to shut down our spontaneous responses, our authentic and essential responses from a very early age. Don't cry. What's wrong? No, don't be scared. I mean, we're talked out of our feelings and shut down because nobody knows how to communicate from an emotional field.
Childhood is tough. Childhood is rough. All the other kids on the playground are telling us what's wrong with us and why we're not okay. And the bad part about it is when you're 7, 8, 9, 10, and 12, you believe it. You don't have the strength to reject it and say that's not true. You take it all in and make it part of your truth.
I was abused by my father when I was younger. And I carried it around. I didn't tell anybody. But it's the weirdest thing because it's one of those events that makes you feel, it's a crime that makes you feel you committed it when you're the victim. Because it isn't all pain. You know, there is pleasure in it. So you carry this around with you, that you were part of the crime. And you'll read this all the time when you hear victims of it speaking. I felt so guilty. And then the last guilt is when your father dies or the person dies and you haven't confronted them about it, and you think, well, time will heal it, and time, but time doesn't heal it. It actually gets worse.
The idea of shadow has to be liberated. We must go into the places that scare us, into the darkness, and make friends with our demons. The wound is the key, because we are all wounded by birth. We are like, where am I? Who am I? Why am I here? Where is he? Where is she? And so we're constantly recreating until we make peace with loneliness and with the shame and with our own anger.
I can't kiss away these tears. I wouldn't miss your edges, your cliffs. They are clay, they are clues gone astray, finding the ones we refuse, and we breathe in the breeze.
Is you have to learn your way through these things. You gotta fight your way through these things. And the big problem is when they medicate teenagers and children. Often at the request of the expert opinion of some fucking teacher that is having a hard time with a creative child, essentially. Now, when you medicate a kid through those years, that kid's not learning how to deal with depression or anger. The discomfort that the child's depression and anger brings the parent or the teacher, the idea that they would medicate him, it's really a selfish thing. It's really the teacher's problem and the parent's problem. So what they wind up doing is medicating these kids. And then the kids find their way, of course, like other teenagers, into self-medication along with that medication. And that's a recipe for disaster. And all these shooters in Columbine, and they've kept Kinkle up in Oregon, and that kid down south were all on antidepressants throughout their teenage years. And what happened was, they got to a point where the rage just blew. Your kid's got a lot of energy. Find something to do with the energy. Get off your ass, mom, dad, and do something, rather than just put a pill into their mouth.
Thank you.
depressive by nature. I'm fairly melancholic by nature. I'm not Captain Chuckles, you know. When things were really bad, that, I mean, things got really bad, I mean, you know, almost to ultimate point, I was offered, you know, happy pills. You know, take a pill. So you take another pill. You take another pill. It doesn't matter. It does matter! I declined them because it's probably wrong, but I just think a human being has to understand the process of this thing, to almost stand back and try and externalize the pain and the anguish and the loss and the grief and look at it and say, what is that? Recognize it. Just so, as I say, you can take out the mirror, I know you, get back in there. I know it. I know who you are.
Facing your demons, all right, being a victim, you know. I am suffering. Everything is always fucked up for me. Nobody understands. And that's a demon, you understand? And it took me years of not being honest with myself, running from the truth, denying what was in my face, blaming everybody else. She's an asshole. She's fucked up. Look at her. Look at them. Look, But then there was a common denominator, me. I had to really fess up, you know? I'm full of shit. I need a colonic. Because I can easily just sink. Yeah, I can sink into the depths.
I have seen trouble. Trouble saw me. I danced around the trouble tree. I have seen beauty staggered on me. I have seen trouble.
Of past emotional pain, and emotional pain that is not fully faced in the moment that it arises, remnants of it become lodged in the body. And that emotional pain is a ball of unhappiness, one could almost call it, that lives in you. I call that the pain body that human beings carry inside. And this is what causes overreactions. Just an innocent comment that your partner makes to you could act as a trigger. Once it's engaged in drama, it doesn't want the drama to end, it wants more. It also goes into your mind. So your thinking becomes deeply negative. Your thinking is fueled by the old emotion. It feeds on every negative thought that it makes you have. It loves negative thinking. One negative thought after another, how dreadful this is. You can hate yourself and tell yourself how much you hate yourself. You can hate your partner and tell yourself how much you hate your partner. Fighting doesn't help. What helps is becoming friendly with it. What does that mean? Say, oh, I can feel this. Look at that. So, and then you feel it. There it is. You allow it to be, you become the observing presence rather than it. And then the old emotion cannot take you over because you're still there. Here's the emotion which you allow to be. You are the space around the emotion. You're not the emotion anymore. That transforms it and it frees you from being its slave. Realize your own thought processes
are creating suffering for yourself. And for most people on this planet, the only spiritual teacher they have is their suffering. And then the suffering becomes an opening.
Trouble will take the back seat. Trouble will take a rest. Trouble knows the fight. Put me to the test. I've held my heart so close to my chest. You leave me wanting. I can't forget.
God has created a void in every man. And the only thing that can fill that void is really God Himself. And when men don't find God, they start looking to fill the void everywhere else. Some will do it with drugs, some will do it with alcohol, some will do it with sex, some will do it with personal achievement, some will become workaholics. So that's what it is. Man is trying to find satisfaction. And he's either going to find it in God or he's going to search for it in vain in things.
Addictions arise in the absence of being in touch with the essential aliveness that you are. Then you need a substitute. I need to smoke. Or an addictive eater. There's enormous need behind it. I need that. Or sex is very clear. You can see how close they all are. You want to take something in because I'm not fulfilled. I need to add more to me, who I think I am, myself. More experience, more knowledge, more suffering. I need more of it, more drama. I need more relationships, more possessions, more time.
يداني دعانا هداني وادعانا يداني دعانا هداني وادعانا يداني دعانا هداني وادعانا يا دان دعانا هداني وادعانا يداني دعانا هداني وادعانا يداني دعانا هداني وادعانا يداني دعانا هداني وادعانا
there is going to be enough to make us happy in this world is what is one of the basic illusions that we carries us through life. We're born hungry in every level. We're hungry for everything. All our senses are hungry for input. When you don't get enough, you think that there is enough somewhere. And until you get enough and realize that it isn't enough and it'll keep coming back, you keep dreaming that romantic image that this will be enough. This relationship, this car, this thing, that, you know, because wanting doesn't stop, no matter how much you get.
All I want is, what I want is, what I get is, once I get it, did I get it? Keep it going up. One, two, yeah, yeah. All I want is, what I want is, what I get is. Yeah, what I want is surface, what I need is something deeper. Lost culture, rap with plastic features. Some vulture came and piqued my interest. Brochures that promise the world no secrets. But what's delivered to me no different, but what's delivered delivers me no different, but what's delivered delivers me no different, but what's delivered delivers me no different. Oh, 给我这个迷彩的颜色，让我早上那个天可以成为了白怀。好与坏，对错每个人在说，或者现在告诉自己不要知道那个沉默。给我这个麦克风的时候开始说唱，每个人控制自己心里的希望，或者现在给我一个机会。
We kind of like live as if we're supposed to be all of us kings all the time and all have everything we want. And when we don't, there's something wrong with us. And we get angry and, you know, we take our suffering so personally. How could this happen to me?
Shelter. Let's say keep working the cards that they dealt you. And if you stand up and fight, then they'll jail you. They sell broken dreams, they can't help you.
Everybody wants to behave just like an American. It's amazing. It's amazing to me. I don't think there are always happy people there. I don't think there are. And there should be unhappy because of what's happening in the community there. It's not enough to have money to be happy. Money doesn't make people happy, but it is peace of mind you have. And I will be surprised if you have peace of mind, because there is no family, individualistic life. Everybody's running after money. We have no time to sit down, talk peacefully, be friends. It's a disaster.
One, without no cash, been a trust fund. Every cat with a gap wanna bust one. Every guest wanna plus one. Every tenement's a penitent. So every tribe man is innocent. Time surge should be the sin spin. Everybody wanna hit a lick. Every one of y'all is getting pimped. Every banknote is promissory. Every broke motherfucker finna form a gang. When we come, we take it. Every Mac want a Cadillac. Every roach is a resident. Every truth ain't evident. Every slave story presentist. Every uprise a consequence. Every time it be something sweet. Every banker is a fucking thief. Everybody better holler with me. Every fiend need $1.50. Every crime that I did was petty. Every criminal is rich already. Every landlord got a complex. Every single is a bomb threat. Every seller may hate my verse. Everybody, they gon' get it first. Every broke motherfucker finna form a gang. And when we come, we taking everything. We won't never know. Sorry, I got caught up looking at my hair and the thing, and it looked like it was messed up. One more time.
We want the food, the clothing, and the shelter. We want the food, the clothing, and the shelter. We want the food, the clothing, and the shelter. They sell broken dreams that can't help us. They sell broken dreams that can't help us.
Thank you.
tu as trouvé là. Ah putain. Ça fait mal pour combien de temps?
Après,
ce qui vient d'ici là, ils font que la même bêtise là. On ne nous donne rien. De quoi on nous promet, après c'est fini, quand on finit de filmer, on part, on a fini. Il est en train de regarder la vieille femme qui est en train de toucher cette tuberculose à la cuisine. C'est tout cela. Après, c'est lui qui aura l'argent. Et même moi, maintenant, je perds l'enfant et mes petits-fils ne verront même pas le visage. Là, c'est un 100 000 francs que vous allez déposer tout de suite.
Pour venir Diobé, tu vas nous Diobé. Si c'est, tu n'es pas Diobé, on va quoi?
minna 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 dem beside you. Jaba minna 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 dem beside you. Tula muyo mi me pullo ye watu ple. Wap koni no atade piyo ye rapenda. Alu jembe de mi mi hore su. Ko, ko, ko suka wano. Ko suka wano ni mi kulka. Ko, ko, ko suka wano.
Raconte de blabla, il nous raconte de conneries. Voilà, donnez-nous vos images. Nous irons faire ceci, nous irons faire cela. Nous sommes fatigués de ça. Nous sommes pauvres. On compte sur vous. C'est par votre aide, par ces images-là. Voyez. Prochainement, vous n'en aurez plus. Même ces images-là vont disparaître. Nous ne parlons, tout le monde nous parle. Car je veux que vive.
I guess it's because we get bombarded and bombarded and bombarded with the images so many times that our brain loses the ability to really react to them. You know, it could be that the pace of the world is blocking out that still small voice of God. You know, everybody's looking for God and the bombardment. You know, earthquakes end. Storms come to an end. The media never shuts off.
Well, they give us the Bible, they give us the Quran, they give us the Talmud, they give us
daily newspapers, the 6 o'clock news, pronouncements by politicians, government policies, sitcoms, advertising, and none of it bears much resemblance at all to what's really going on in the universe. And when's the last time you heard anyone complain?
TV is an emanation of the triumph of the blasé. I want to say I think it's a disgrace. How can the blasé be triumphing so? They can't possibly have a good army. I mean, they're blasé. They're not known for their gung-ho. but they're kicking ass right now. The blasé are kicking ass. I could see how a blasé saint could be a good thing. But to have blasé as the status quo for everybody, that's a supreme bummer. That's a gigantic psychological limitation.
I used to talk more than I used to listen. Now I reverse my position. Now I can spot with precision those on a mission and those who love me, the dissing of those who seem to suppose they govern me. The unpretty, the ugly, the unlovely can no longer hope to escape discovery. I let them relax and fatigue. None of them have no real quality to them. Philosophy, I just mean me. Coming like a cancer upon we. Society cannot sustain them, cause I'm too greedy. Communicating lively but without a sound. This is what makes my world go round. Communicating lively but without a sound. This is what makes my world go round. Makes my world go round.
You are dominated by the corporate powers. They never leave you alone. They are with you in the bedroom. So you are never alone. So there is no choice. You think you choose, but you do not choose.
And we have huge propaganda systems. Public relations industry is fundamentally a propaganda system. It's an enormous industry. Developed first in Britain and the United States. These are the two countries that were most free and democratic. And that's where you need a propaganda system. Because there, you can't control people by force anymore. So you have to control their beliefs and attitudes. And this is very conscious. The core of democracy is the engineering of consent. And you're directed, you know, by the educational system, by the media, to have the aspiration of becoming a millionaire. And then if you don't quite make it, you didn't meet your aspiration. But there are other values, you know. There's another value to say, okay, I won't be a millionaire, but I'll help people who really need help. And you don't have to go to Ethiopia to find this. You can do it right in the United States. Letters from young people in Canada and the United States and England and so on saying, you know, I don't like what's going on, what can I do? Interestingly, I never get that question from people in poor countries. They don't ask me what they should do, they tell me what they're doing. It's only in the wealthy, privileged sectors that people have no idea what to do. Elsewhere, they do things. And that's part of our education and indoctrination, to make you feel there is nothing you can do. And it has to really be imposed strenuously in the richer and more powerful countries, because you can do a lot. In fact, you can do anything.
I can't communicate with myself. I can't communicate with the wealth of communication. Age, information, truth always changing. So free occasion, so many ways to say things. You can silence.
I find peace of mind? How do I find that place inside of me where I can stop listening to this inner noise and start really listening?
Voice. You have all of this chatter that you have to kind of clear out. Your parents, your aunts, your grandmama's voice, everybody's voice is in your head.
You. Yeah, I mean, it's a pretty chorus thing, isn't it? You are a
I believe that for a second. Just might sound. You think
it's trying to work well.
See, there goes my life.
It's fucking up. Masturbation.
Stop, pump the brakes. So it's just a switch in the internal tape and weeding out all of that external and historical stuff.
There's no way out. We are all stuck in our minds.
I think one of the common misunderstandings about meditation is that you empty your mind and you become very still and there is this void, you know. Actually, what happens when you sit in meditation is you feel very, very uncomfortable. You know, your mind's going crazy. It's like it's trapped in a cage and it wants to get out and you don't want to be there. You want to be down the pub or watching television or doing anything, but you don't want to be there looking at this wall, you know. So it is uncomfortable and it should be uncomfortable. That's the process. It's like it's your ability to stay with that, to actually begin to explore a very simple question in a way. Why is it uncomfortable? Why is it so uncomfortable to be still?
To appreciate the present moment, there needs to be a gap in the stream of thinking, most of which is unnecessary, some of it is useful, but most of it actually interferes with the smooth flow of life. It creates so much suffering, so many problems that actually have no existence here and now. Part of the madness is to live as if the future were more important than the present moment, which is how most people live. It's completely insane. So you miss the aliveness of life for some projected future aliveness or fulfillment. There is no future, there's only this, the present moment. Stillness is already here. It's an essential part of who you are. And all you need to do is get in touch with that. How do I get in touch with that? The easiest way is to become friendly with the present moment. Even if the present moment is noisy, you become friendly with the noise of the present moment, and then there's a background of stillness. Can you sense that you are? No. This is it. This is it. It's always going to be this. And this is who you are. I am. And to sense that is joyful. And that joy is not through anything external. It's inherent.
Bare bare aadasha habina.
say die. You make me wanna be a better guy. I wonder why.
The human being is great. It is a great, you are good. You know, this is important to get your basic goodness and stop beating yourself up.
We have this peculiar shame about ourselves. We have this contingent state of worrying about why we are and feeling bad about it. We feel bad about the fact that we masturbate, that we shit, that we have to have sex in order to reproduce. What is to be ashamed of in that? I mean, how bizarre that the state that we are given. This is how you make another one of yourself. You put this penis into that vagina and you pump out lots of seed and another baby gets made. And we spend our lives not allowing that to be on television, as if it is something to be ashamed. And words that describe it, like fuck or cunt or something, are made taboo words. Whereas kill, cruel, torture, we could use those words when just describing the traffic. And they're not taboo words, but those are things we do of which we should be absolutely ashamed. Completely ashamed.
These amazing lovers, and that they need each other, they balance each other, they hold each other, they embrace each other. At a certain point in the day, every day, they like touch each other as they pass, you know? And then there's this third force, the shadow, which is kind of the ego part, the part that separates the night from the dark and puts us in a position of thinking we have to be like a good girl or a good boy or a good person instead of being a real person and a vulnerable person. We just don't trust. We've been taught not to.
If you substitute content for happy, you'll probably find that you're happy. Because we've associated happiness with laughing, you know, and smiling and throwing beach balls to your children. And I've never been that guy. So I thought, well, maybe I'm not happy. But if you switch it for content, the practice of contentment, you think, oh, God, I'm happy. I'm a happy man. Oh, look at me.
And we've all got something to be thankful for. Stop bitching. Stop complaining. Stop worrying. Worrying is praying for what you don't want. So stop praying for what you don't want and just let go.
The world is beautiful, placed here from the love of mama, passed down from my papa, voices from beyond they call me, wisdom speaks loud from the corners, and each step that moves me on, isn't it the same for you? Isn't this the honest truth? The seeds for us, the things that we should trust. It's all about me, it's all about you. All the lies, all the truth, the use. usual, the unusual, the known, the unknown. It's so beautiful. But I pray, please lift me up and help me stand. We're moving on just hand in hand. But it always comes back down to me, to you, to me. Each step moves us up. Here we go. Onward, forward, still must go. Each step moves us up. Here we go. Onward, forward, still must go. Each step moves us up. Here we go.
And now I'm old, more than 80. I'm not afraid of death, you see. To be or not to be, that's the question. If I could not move, if I could not work freely, if I could not hear, I could not see, I could not lead, what's the use of living? Living would not be. If to live is a delight, then live on. Live as long as you can. If to be is not good, then you be not to be, I think.
I'm not afraid of death. What I'm afraid of is old age. Once you get old, you become weak, you become powerless, don't know what to do. You can see people working. You know how to do it, but you cannot do it. This is what I'm starting to feel now.
In my case, there's a fear of not doing all I want to do before dying, because I feel that I still have time, no? There's still sun on the walls, no? But it's a sun that's coming down. It's given me a sense of loneliness I didn't have before, a sense of solitude, a sense of, for instance, young people keep to themselves, so all the people need to have friends more or less their age, but then those friends die and disappear. I keep losing people all over the years, and young people have their own lives. They have their own time. They don't have time for others, no? Or they pay polite visits or polite conversation or how are you, but you see that they want to go. I never think of myself wrinkled, no? I never think that I have white hair. But I do have a sensation sometimes. When I glimpse myself in the mirror, I say, how ugly. And that is sad.
As you get old, it's a constant process of loss. I have lost so many good friends. One very recently, dear, dear friend who died suddenly about a month ago. And that's very upsetting. And you lose parents, of course, and they're unfortunate, sometimes children, certainly friends, and power. Your eyes, your ears, your ability to run, to get up. It takes 5 minutes to get up off a chair and get moving. Those are big losses. And that's what we deal with, is the loss. I guess death is the final loss. You lose yourself.
Yukuni.
My friends, they tell me, why don't you make a facelift, you know, to hide your wrinkles? Why should I hide my wrinkles? I am above 70. I am proud of my age. I am proud of my wrinkles.
But there's an added something. Now let me think about what that might be. The sense that life is not limitless. And I'm sitting with people who are stupidly wasting their time. I'm a better therapist because I'm impatient with that. I don't excuse it, and I say, well, you know, that's who they are. You know, my tendency is to want to shake them up and say, wait, the days are getting shorter. Wake up.
Aging is going from a perceptual stance of ego to a perceptual stance of soul. You become wisdom. You don't have to know anything. You become wisdom. You become compassionate. And you give up all the striving.
Ame Puchu Chigdendi Devoridu Simchi Tamchi Tungine Deva Kyushu Kine Bula Beda Bula Beda
Anywhere where I drop the body, that's the perfect place to die.
And we each die at our appointed time. That's beautiful. That, yeah.
If you can face death, if you can look death in the eye, then he will reward you by letting you live, really live, every second that you have left.
Kaseli kadua kasara kabo manyesro kola kayele yele nanke masa alala netumbe yele kanyanyini kaseli kadua kasara kabo manyesro kola kayele yele nanke masa alala tumbe yele kanyanyini kaseli kadua kasara kabo manyesro kola kayele yele nanke masa alala.
Friends who were diagnosed together around the same time died this summer. To sit with them and know that they're dying and know that what they're experiencing could be what you experience can be very frightening. It's just, there's really no way to put into words the loss that you feel for that. The other side to that is that when your friend is dying and in bed and can't talk and all you can do is wave your finger at each other, you know that there's a tremendous amount of love there. Money doesn't count. Possessions don't count. I'm beginning to find myself again, but I don't know what my survival will be. And then I think, well, does anyone really know what their survival is going to be?
Yeah, I'm going to light this and just say a short prayer. Because if you involve God in your work, you have to succeed. There's no failure. This opens the spiritual eye in your brain. Okay? The spiritual eye. Because most of our brain we never use, you know. And that's the spiritual side that we should cultivate to serve God properly. Here's the last.
The central dynamic of history is not a conflict between God and Satan. It's not a conflict between good and evil. It's a conflict between ignorance and enlightenment.
It would be easy to become religious, I think. It's an effort not to, not in an orthodox sense, but seriously to suddenly just depart from all the sciences and decide that there is a completely unidentified set of quite detailed and purposeful forces that are driving us.
It's never random. There's nothing random in the universe. But at the most fundamental levels of nature, there's one single pattern in which you and I and our thoughts and our behaviors and our interactions are actually part of an overall pattern.
It makes no sense to me, none of it. You know, we're not very significant as creatures, you know. It's over. It begins, it's over. And for me, it's a blessed oblivion. Nothing, the absolute thrill of nothing, you know, the relief of nothing. God, nothing, nothing, wow.
The more you can be an individual and be all of it at the same time, you've got it made.
Mere Gurudev Charanon Par Suman Shraddha Ke Arpit Hain. Tumhi ho bhav mein mere vicharon mein pukaro. Tumhi ho bhav mein mere vicharon mein pukaro. Ab mujhko mere sarvatra samarpit hai. Mere Gurudev charanon par suman shraddha ke arpit hai.
O son and daughter of noble birth, now the time has come for you to seek a path. As your breath stops, visions will appear, and while on this journey from life into death, if you should find yourself calling out, O Lord of great compassion, am I beautiful enough? Am I wearing the right clothes? Do I have the right connections to get me into where I'm going? To these concerns, I say, do not worry. With this kiss, there are revelations tattooed upon our lips. Revelations more easily read on account of this silent pact with recognition, where I'm beginning to see that we are slowly becoming healed.
So I can heal myself, to feel myself, be real myself. Life's addictions and afflictions cause abrasion from the fiction. Sometimes it's easier to live in fiction. I can run, but I can't hide from the pains that reside down deep inside. There is no pill that can be swallowed. There is no guru that can be followed.
So it's a great opportunity for construction, for new ideas, for getting closer to the truth and moving past organized religion and make it real and deal with the chaos and the pain while you're home into the universe. That's heaven and hell right there that we're walking every day with it. You can change it. You can live hell tomorrow and be in heaven today, right now. It's nothing esoteric out there. It's right here.
There's no escaping from my own history. Those that I hurt and those that hurt me. I was dead for a million years before I was born. I'll be dead for a million more after I'm gone. So I live to give something that can live on. Like the way you hum a song when the music's gone. Like the warmth of the sand when the sun goes down. I'm sitting with myself, nobody else is around.
You know what, whether Lord is Buddha or Jesus or Allah or whatever, if he's a god, he's gonna know you're a cool guy and you ain't gotta worry. If there's a heaven, you're going.
I say, why must I feel like this today? I'm a soldier, but afraid. Sometimes to face the things that may block the sun from shining rays. fill my life with shades of gray. Still I long to find a way. So today I pray for grace. I'm grateful for my life today. Cause none of us can live a perfect life. The kind that we see only at night. And sometimes we all just lose sight of the pain that will guide us from dark into light. When we fall down, yes, we get up. And sometimes we just need a little bit of love to help to make it through another day. And through the night into light into a Saturday. So in the morning when I'm waiting for the sun to raise, and my head's a little foggy like I'm in a haze, I remind myself that every little good thing is gonna be okay, okay. I take a breath, slow down and say yes.
Be here now. Be in this moment. We live in a dream. Our lives are fragile. All of us have one foot on a banana peel and the other foot on the grave. The surrender is not an option because you can only fight it so long. It's a cork floating in the middle of the ocean, screaming, I must control it, I must have control. It's hard to just let life happen.
Yesterday, I'm a soldier, full of bravery.
Stormy sky.